people the good news of his salvation. That we, and the whole world, may perceive the glory of his marvelous works, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Second reading is from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. I mean, brothers and sisters, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing, and those who buy as though they had no possession. And those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it. For the present form of this world is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God, saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
So when Jesus saw these young men casting out their nets into the sea, He approached them and invited them face to face. He went a little further when he saw the two other brothers, James and John, and walked up to them with a personal invitation, and they followed. The personal touch attracts us. Cards and letters are meaningful, but only do so much. Advertising is impressive, but impersonal. But a handshake, an authentic smile, that makes a huge difference. Huge difference. It's the point where the essence of one person actually touches another person. The human touch is the foundation of loving our neighbors. The core of God's instruction, love your neighbor as yourself. And yet, many people don't touch, or worse, can't touch. Maybe it's because smartphones and texting and social media. Maybe it's because we're afraid to risk getting rejected or hurt. Maybe it's because we're comfortable and lazy. Maybe it's because we just forgot how to fish for people. Now, we all know that pelicans are great fishers, right? Yeah, you know that, right? Okay, good. Well, there was a group of pelicans who were hanging out in near a fleet of fishing boats. And after a day at sea, they'd pull in the boats, and they'd clean the fish and throw the heads and the rest back into the water. And the pelicans picked up on it and ate all the leftovers. Well, without having to go fishing. And if you're a pelican, that's good eating. So they just sat on the pilings and they waited for the fishing boats to come in, get their breakfast, lunch, or dinner. And after a while, the fishermen learned that they could actually sell the fish waste and turn the pelican food into cash. So they stopped chucking it into the water. The birds were completely unprepared. They just sat on those pilings, hungry, waiting. They grew thinner and thinner until some wildlife officials realized that the pelicans had forgotten how to fish. So they brought in pelicans from another area to join the flock and teach the starving birds how to fish again. So, are we like those pelicans? Have we forgotten how to fish? There's a little-known fishing club on the intercoastal waterway. Its walls are covered with sailfish, tarpon, sharks, and bonefish. Photos of dolphins, snapper, and grouper are stacked by sunburned men and women. And they tell fish stories in air-conditioned comfort, but they don't fish anymore. The lure of the cast, the thrill of the strike, the white knuckles on the reel, no longer relevant. A fishing club for people who don't fish. Year after year, there were fewer and fewer and fewer, until there was no one left. Some churches are like that. They talk about the days when the sanctuary was packed with people, and they had 150 kids in their youth group, and the whole church was so exciting, and they told everyone about it. But now, there's no fire in the belly, no passion for Christ. In spite of that, people need God today, more than ever. How will they ever know God's love if no one invites them? The colic for today, the prayer at the beginning of the service I read, give us grace, O Lord, to answer readily the call of our Savior Jesus Christ, to proclaim to all the people the good news of his salvation, and we and the whole world may receive the glory of his marvelous works. Thursday morning Bible study, I asked people, were you called by God to follow Jesus? And they all said, yes. I said, what about you? Were you called by God to follow Jesus? Were you invited into everlasting life? Were you? Huh?
Yes.
Yes? Not sure? Let me ask you again. Were you called by God to follow Jesus?
Yes.
Were you invited into everlasting life?
Yes.
Okay. Now that you remembered what you agreed to do with your baptism, remember that? Turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior, right? Yes. Put your whole trust in his grace and love, yes?
Yes.
Promise to follow and obey him as your Lord.
Yes.
You answered the call. You agreed to follow. We are called to be fishers of people. Not just keepers. Not members of the fishing club where no one goes fishing. Actual fishermen. I can hear you thinking, well, that's nothing. That's not my gift. I'm an introvert. I'm no theologian. Excuses after excuses. The truth is, all of you can do this. Everyone can do it. You can fish for people. So here are some fishing tips. First, go where the fish are. You catch more redfish in the St. Lucie River than on I-95. Same is true when you fish for people. Go where they are. Don't wait for them to come to you. Ask questions. Be willing to listen. You can't get to know people if you do all the talking. Be kind, responsive, and real. Second, be creative. You're not a door-to-door salesman hawking magazine subscriptions. You don't need to close the sale. Just be a friend. That's all. Don't get all churchy. You don't need to recite the Nicene Creed from memory. Or try to explain the nature of the Trinity. Although Father Bill would love to do that. Keep it simple. God loves you more than you know, and he finds you fascinating. Next, be patient. These conversations are about building friendships, not getting results. Expect surprises. One of my parishioners had a conversation with an older woman and learned that her uncle was the Pope. Her uncle was the Pope. Another group that I was with was talking about Albert Einstein, and one woman spoke and said, he was such a nice man. We all whipped our heads around sheepishly. He was my next door neighbor when I was a kid. I was over at his house all the time. Albert Einstein. Step out of your comfort zone, take a risk, smile, and cast a line. Be on the lookout for signs of God at work. He is definitely on the move, especially right here in this church in Port St. Lucie, in Holy Faith. Pay attention. And then tell others. Guess what happened this week? Really? And then finally, pray. Don't try to do this on your own. God will give you the right words at the right time. He will. You can do this, so let's go fishing. Amen.
Amen.
pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we may all be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all you.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Justin, our bishop, Father Rob, our priest in charge, Father Bill, and other ministers. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world. Joe Biden, our president, Ron DeSantis, our governor, and Shannon Martin, our mayor. Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. Give to the departed eternal rest. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. I ask your prayers for the sick, especially Alvin, Ariane, Althea, Arlene, Austin, Beverly, Blake, Blossom, Rachel, Caitlin, Caillou, Carol, Caroline, Cindy, Aon, Crystal, Curtis, Debbie, Dido, Dennis, Dwayne, Donald, Lisette, Estella, Father Bill, Gail, Jeanette, Gloria, Gus, Handel, Hazel, Herman, Howard, Ivy, Jamie, Jason, Jean, Jennifer. Jessica, Joey, John, Joseph, Kate, Keith, Khalil, Kyle, Leandas, Laser, Lena, Leroy, Linda, Lloyd, Lorraine, Lou, Martha, Mary, Marianne, Marlene, Melrose, Michael, Mariah, Obi, Owen, Patricia, Pearl, Priscilla, Randall, Reverend Tracy, Rona, Richard, Rose, Roy, Ruby, Ruth, Sean, Shirley, Sydney, Serena, Stafford, Stephanie, Suzanne, Tamar, Terry, Teresa, Terry, Thomas Smith family, Trey, Verona, Esther, Victor, Vincent, Vivian, Wayne Jr., and William. We pray for the men and women in our armed forces, saying,
Almighty God,
we commend your gracious care and keeping
all the men and women of our armed forces at home and abroad, especially Ashley, Omar, Peter, and Helene. Defend them day by day with your heavenly grace. Strengthen them in their trials and temptations. Give them courage to make things for them. Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty and eternal God, Lord of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. My heart, we have done.
you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit to keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please stand. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Thank you.
Savior Christ taught us, we are bold to say. Christ our Lord. And the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you now and remain with you always.
Amen.
Announcements.
So loud, man.
Start, I don't know. Thursday night, Friday night, said that Wednesday and Sunday are their slowest days. I don't anticipate a whole lot of problem. I think our best approach is to make friends with them and see what we can get from them. he was quite generous. This guy, he said that when we have functions, if we need parking, he'd be glad to let us park in his facility. I believe he never looked at the place, or else he would have seen that we don't need extra parking. But the construction, I believe, is going to come right up to the ridge line.
Okay.
And there's going to be fencing and shrubbery set up. And that's about all I can offer. If anybody has any questions, see me later in the parish hall. There's going to be another hearing when they have it. We'll go back and listen to what they have to say.
One of the things is that they didn't present that there was a church building adjacent to their property. So that was not taken into consideration. When we spoke about the church and the disruption that we would encounter, was when they asked for, they said they had, they were asked if they had met with any of the people who responded, because there were a lot of people who sent in a letter stating that they object to the construction. And they were asked if they had met with any of the people, and the answer was no. And they said they tried to reach us, but we didn't respond, which was not true. However, the fact that it was brought to the county's attention that there's a church adjacent to the property, they have decided to postpone it and have another hearing. And we are encouraging everyone to go to the hearing. Okay.
When is the hearing?
We don't know yet.
I did show on the map.
It's the U-Haul that gave their presentation. One question that the commission asked was if they had met with residents in the area.
Yeah.
And the answer was no. So
no.
I said, we have a facility that can accommodate 200 people. Whenever you need to have a gathering to voice, tell the community about what your plans are, we'd be glad to accommodate you.
Good move.
Well, we did get the name of the gentleman, Cal O'Connor.
Okay.
I googled his name afterwards, and yes, he is the president of Florida East New Orleans, so we're going to stand on Mr. O'Connor's back.
One of the panelists did say that they should not have any
construction
on, or any business on Sundays.
Yeah.
That was a suggestion, right?
Yeah.
Sunday, the office will be closed for business.
That'd be good, at least in the morning. I can open up afternoon maybe. But that'd be helpful. I mean, we really don't want to hear hammering and nailing and chiseling and machines running into our service. We don't need to. I don't think that's
nobody look at map.
Okay, anything else, Claudette?
No, that's it. The annual parish meeting is, of course, is held in the parish hall.
Yep.
And we are inviting all to come.
All right, let's sing and then we'll go over.
Glory. sick.